What's up, everybody? Welcome to Gaming Tech. Today we're taking a deep dive on this system. This is a portable monitor, by the way, that we will be using to display our temperatures. We will be taking a closer look at the temperatures of this system. Here we can see our temperatures. The reason I put this monitor so you guys can see the entire temperature situation even better. It was pretty warm in the room when I was filming this. It ended up being 34 degrees. We will be power limited at some point. I just increased the speed here to 200% because I don't want to bore you with the temperatures. As you see, the temperatures, they're crazy high. And we're running the system on Windows high performance mode. I didn't choose to use ultimate performance. Then the CPU would clock even more, and then we would be hitting thermal throttle even more. You can see our temperatures here. The system is with the glass panel on. As you see, with the glass panel on, it crashed. I had to remove the glass, and we're checking why it crashed. These are the idle temperatures right now after the crash. As you see, they're extremely high, and Cooler Master CPU cooler cannot handle this. Like, RPM speed of 1100 is very low, very low. It's not even about the RPM speed here. It's about that cooling with the heat pipes taking the heat dissipation situation. But here, since there's no heat pipes, nothing involved, there's just a bare copper underneath the CPU cooler and an aluminium block. That's about it. You see the temperature coming out. It's pretty warm. This was tough to do, guys. Definitely it was tough. Like, you could cook some chicken inside a computer case. Like, what is this temperature? It's unpleasant in summer. As you see, Cinebench decided to glitch out. That would be an amazing score, but we want to take a look at the temperature, so it doesn't matter if the stuff is glitching out. We wanted to put maximum amount of pressure on the computer, and here we can see the temperatures. We achieved that point at least. Like, this is... I hope they will improve the temperature situation, because next week on Sunday, it's expected to be 39 degrees here, and it's gonna get much worse at that point. Here, I'm just deciding to remove the glass panel because the computer is just choking. We remove the glass panel here. We can see the clock speed went up a little bit. The computer is getting fresh air in at this point. Closer look at our temperatures. Here we're running it. Time spy in the background. As you see, much better temperatures when you just remove the side panel. It does a huge difference for this system. Graphic card, we kept it on the auto mode. We didn't manipulate anything. We're basically running as auto. You just booted up the computer. Windows is set on high performance mode. Nothing else is done. GPU is not tweaked. Power mode is normal. There you go. There you go. Now we're taking a closer look at the GPU. This is in auto mode. God damn, that is hot. Like, 80 degrees on that Zotac cooler. That is insane. Let's look at our components. How are they doing? Backplate was so warm that I almost burned myself. 70 to 80 degrees, like if it feels very hot to touch. And on couple of cores, we just hit 100. As you see, the CPU package, 91 degrees, CPU core max. This is basically everything with glass panel removed and everything in auto mode. Horrible score, horrible score. Let's take a closer look. I did 3 tests. Auto mode, 100% on the GPU mode. Then the thermal paste got changed. And then I put an AIO. I thought I had an air cooler. Unfortunately, I couldn't find one for this test. So I decided to use an AIO, but I added just one single fan. We see our peak temperatures here. This is in completely stock mode. Outside temperature wasn't helping the situation either. It's all about cooling, guys. Once you improve the cooling, you will see the scores change drastically. As you see here, much better. We're still running stock, by the way. Only glass side panel removed and graphic card is on 100%. And let's not forget about those 12mm fans in the case. I said before that they were 14mm, but I measured them, they're 12mm. Fan that spins up to 600 RPM. Once you use the graphic card on 100%, it pushes a lot of the warm air that is trapped inside the case outside. Because let's think about it, the graphic card is consuming around 350 watts. I found these fans laying around. These are the Nocta industrial fans. The other one is the Corsair AIO fan. It spins up to 2500 RPM. They're all loud fan. I put them on the bottom. I put one here, complete ghetto mode. You shouldn't even call this mode. It's just removing the cooler was very easy job. There's gonna be a detailed video about this, how to apply thermal paste and everything else. I measured the processor temperature here. It was sitting roughly 40 degrees. You see the thermal paste, horrible, horrible. Cooler itself is horrible also. Here I installed the AIO with the single fan. Super easy job to do. I didn't have to remove the backplate of the motherboard either. Do you see? Huge difference. Okay, for air cool setup, it's not exactly comparable, but since I had this laying around, I intended to use the AIO here just to prove that you can improve the temperatures. If I had an air cooler, which I thought I had, the Arctic one, I guess I gave it away to somebody. It's a difference there. You will see score going up. Nothing is tweaked here. Here we see the PUBG temperature. Nobody wants to run their system like this, obviously. You see the CPU, it goes up to 62 degrees and nothing else. And this is with single fan. FPS got boosted. And by the way, we're not running on ultimate performance mode here. That's why the CPU clock ratio is that. With our temperatures being low, we could have boosted much more higher. But as you see, how amazing AIOs are. And by the way, this is a Corsair H100 V2. Very old AIO, in fact. At the time it was coming with 5-year warranty. I have no idea what Corsair is doing with their AIOs right now. Amazing temperatures. You can't complain. Everything runs super smooth. There we jumped to a 63 degree. It was very interesting test. You're gonna ask me, does thermal paste make a difference? Yes. In this case, since in stock cooler, I don't know what kind of thermal paste they use, but it's gonna be probably pretty low quality. I had thermal paste from Arctic MX4, I believe. It's pretty decent one. And the system wasn't even loud. You can have the GPU at around 60 to 70%, and you're gonna have very nice computer. Can you add a AIO in the system? Maybe on the exhaust port. You can deattach the exhaust fan and add a 120mm there. The biggest reason you end up having high temperatures on this system is because of the air not being pushed out. GPU produces a lot of heat, CPU produces equally. No, CPU doesn't produce equally, but relatively high amount also. Because when I deattached the cooler, it was very warm. This is a great system. Once you improve the temperatures, it's a very nice machine. Can't complain. And this grenade sound scared the shit out of me. Because I was looking at the temperatures during the gaming on the other monitor, and suddenly that bomb sound. And that wasn't pleasant at all. I'm gonna be showing how to apply thermal paste, the way I do it at least. And how we remove the cooler, master cooler as well, on a separate video. Reason for that is this video ended up being too long anyway because of the temperature testing. I don't want to bore out people. Whoever is interested in the temperatures can watch the temperature. Whoever wants to remove the cooler can watch the cooler, and so on. We see 60 degrees here. I'm pretty impressed by that AIO. I used to use it back in day for 8700K. Overclocked to 5 GHz. Amazing cooler. We jumped there to 62, dropped. As you see, water and air is not comparable. But if you use a Noctua cooler here, or I'm gonna actually have a detailed video of that, which coolers you should be using on different budget once I get them in. You're gonna see drastic improvement. 59, just chilling here in PUBG. God damn, it was so warm in the room. 34 degrees in the room. Let's move on. Here I'm cleaning the system back with the old cooler, back to the old stock cooler temperatures. Remember, we had 36. Obviously, if you put it to a balanced mode, it's gonna go down, and here you can see the temperature once again. We're above 80 degrees. And here, this is putting a stress on only on the CPU, 85 degrees. Let's look at our scores. The first one is stock. Green one is our total score. Gray is in auto mode. Second one is with only new paste. And the third one is with three fans. And we have the AIO score as well. The Frankenstein setup. It looks funny. Shame I didn't have an air cooler, because I wanted to close the glass and test it again. But just add two fans and everything will get fixed. I had fun. Hope you guys had fun. If you have any questions, you can ask them on the comment section. Thank you for watching. Once again, thank you for coming. Have a great night. See you on next video. Let's go, guys.